moving to get us closer to the man that we're all waiting for, the next president of the United States, Donald J. Trump.
Let's begin. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible.
Play ball. I like that. We have 6 days remaining. 6 days remaining in early voting. Election day, 9 days away. Are you ready to make America great again on November 8th? Are you ready? Right now? Now, if you listen to Live and Local Now every morning, 9 to noon, on 790 Talk Now, Talk the Rocks, you know that we talk a lot about early voting and why early voting is so desperately important to making sure that Donald J. Trump is the next president of the United States. By your applause, how many have early voted already? That's good. How many of you have not early voted so far? That's a lot of you. Well, today we're going to make it so easy to early vote. I'm so excited about this. The nearest early voting polling location is at the Boulevard Mall at Desert Inn and Maryland Parkway. It would be easy to tell you to just make the short drive to the polls so you can cast your ballot. That would be the easy way. But Mr. Trump wants to make it even easier for you to really go. As soon as the rally ends, I want you to go to the valet parking area here at the Venetian. We have a fleet of large black buses waiting to drive you to the polls and back so you can cast that ballot for Donald J. Trump. Our first speaker this morning, I've always wanted to meet. He lives in the same town I live in, but I've never met him. Rick Harrison is a local businessman best known for the number one show in the country, Pawn Stars. He is also extremely active in the Las Vegas community. He has raised countless dollars for those who truly need it most. Rick is a true testament to the American dream, a great father, a great husband. And we couldn't be more honored to welcome him to the stage. Please welcome the owner of the world-famous gold and silver pawn shop, Rick Harrison. I'm sorry, Rick Harrison, it's not. You know, I'm going to tell you a little inside story. It almost always happens when you give somebody a big buildup like that. I do it on the radio all the time. And you say, and now, joining us from Washington, D.C. or from New York, and then all of a sudden, they're not there. You give them a big building. Well, this is a guy that needs no introduction. I don't even need an intro for Wayne Allen Root. He is my colleague on 790 Talk Now, Talk That Rocks. He is, I first saw Wayne at a Donald J. Trump rally, I think back in January or February. I was way back there. He was right here. And he made the not-so-bold promise. He said, I'm going to spend every waking hour between now and the primaries to make sure Donald J. Trump is the nominee of the Republican Party. He has stayed true to that promise. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Wayne Allen Root.
By the way, Rick Harrison of Pawn Stars is on the way. He's trying to fight through this massive crowd to get in. So thank you for this massive crowd. So hello, deplorables. Hello, irredeemables. Hello, rednecks. Hello, Trump. And this citizen revolution is led by conservatives, angry Republicans who hate establishment rhinos, independents, working class Americans, Christians, gun owners, small business owners, military veterans, and taxpayers. That's the coalition to take back this country. And as I look out at this incredible sea of conservative patriots and warriors alive and well and growing right here in Las Vegas, Nevada, all I can say is, welcome to the Trump Revolution! The peasants, the serfs, and the taxpayers with pitchforks, jackhammers, and blowtorches are heading for Washington, D.C. Can you hear us? We're putting the D.C. elite on notice. We're coming to tear it down. We're coming to rip it up. We're coming to kick your ass. And we're coming to put you in prison. Lock her up. Lock her up. Lock her up. Lock her up. All right. So I was the first commentator in this country to predict that Trump would beat out 17 others and win the GOP nomination. I was the first to predict he'd win this election and become President Donald Trump. I never believed in the polls. In the face of awful, fake polls, 2 weeks ago, I went on national TV all over this country, and I told them that I went to England, and I made a bet at an English sports bet, the biggest bet of my entire life, on Donald J. Trump to win the presidency. And I say that my bet is looking pretty good today. As of yesterday, in Ohio, a Hillary Clinton rally starring Bill Clinton, 50 people show up.
that will work. Everything everyone wants to do will not work, and it'll be really hard for him to like be president in a jail cell.
Donald Trump has promised to make sure that all
now I've got to know the family. And I want to tell you, David Tarkanian has a lot of great volunteers. His best volunteer is only 11 years old. Where is David? She's somewhere out there. There she is. There's nobody that works homes better than Ava Tarkanian. Ladies and gentlemen, I am so pleased to introduce to you our next member of Congress. Congratulations, David Tarkanian. he is the longest serving chairman of the Nevada Republican Party. Please welcome my friend, Michael McDonald.
Thank you. to me, it's so inspirational. The things that got me thinking about is we are a nation. We are a nation that needs to heal. We are a nation that needs to unify. And we are a nation that needs leadership. And Donald Trump is going to bring that leadership. This is not about the corruption or the cronies or the criminal behavior of the past. We want to put Hillary Clinton in our rearview mirror. And you'll hear this, you've seen this, we want to drain that swamp. And drain it big time. Drain that swamp big time. Get that room. It's so terrible. You know, we've seen wicked leaders and unclassified servers. We have another federal investigation opening up. I mean, on a personal basis, he's being aware of it. Unbelievable. I mean, we've got a name calling. I will not allow myself to be called a deplorable American. No way. I am not deplorable. I'm an American veteran. I love this country. I serve this country. You're all veterans here. Shout out.
Do you think anybody is going to wait 1 minute to vote for Hillary Clinton? I doubt it. people who are working so hard in this campaign. I want to thank Ken Evans. Thank you so much, Ken. I want to thank three members of Congress, Congresswoman Debbie Wasserman Schultz, Congressman Alcee Hastings, and your Congresswoman Lois Frankel. I also want to thank Sheriff Israel for being here, and Mayor Resnick just gave me a key to the city of Wilton Manors. And I want to thank my longtime friend and such a great leader, Chad Griffin, Human Rights Campaign president. I know that Chad told me there are a bunch of Human Rights Campaign organizers. And, you know, as I've said many times, HRC for HRC sounds good to me.
Deliberate, intentional, and purposeful. terms of shielding her criminal conduct from public disclosure and exposure. She set up this illegal server knowing full well that her actions put our national security at risk and put the safety and security of your children at risk. To cover up her crimes, she bleached and deleted 33,000 emails after receiving a congressional subpoena. She gets a subpoena, and she deletes and bleaches, and nobody even ever heard of bleaching. Did anybody ever hear of bleaching? No, it's just as expensive as possible. But a Mexico, but I have a feeling you just found a lot of them. We never thought we were going to say thank you to Andy Weiner. She made 13 phones disappear some of the time. She lied to Congress under oath. She lied to the FBI many times. And then two boxes of email evidence just recently went mysteriously missing. Then you have the WikiLeaks revelations, which have exposed criminal corruption at the highest levels of our government. Hillary put the office of Secretary of State up for sale, and if she ever did get the chance, which we're not going to let her have, she put the Oval Office up for sale. To protect Hillary Clinton. They didn't try to protect our generals, they didn't try to protect a lot of other people. How can the Attorney General be involved in this case or tell the FBI what to do when the Attorney General violated sanctity of law by secretly meeting with Bill Clinton, the husband of the possible target of the investigation, and a possible target himself, in an airplane on the tarmac in Arizona? Remember who's going to play golf, remember? But he just happened to be at the airport hanging around, and the Attorney General's plane drove by. So why is she now allowed to fight so hard to get someone who is so obviously guilty on so many different fronts off the hook? In fact, it was publicly reported that sources close to Hillary Clinton said, and she actually, I think, said it in the papers, that she was thinking of reappointing Attorney General Lynch. You're talking about, you're going to reappoint. the principles on which our nation was founded. When the powerful can get away with anything because they have the money and the connections to rig the system, then the people lose hope and confidence in the future of their country. Corruption is corrosive to the soul of democracy, and it must be stopped. We're going to stop. Because we have one ultimate check on Hillary's corruption, and that is the power of the vote. The power of the vote. The only way to beat the corruption is to show up and vote by the tens of millions, including millions of people, voting for the first time in their lives. people are tired. We're tired, we're sick and tired. And don't say I was on the other side for a long time, folks. I understand that side very well. And it's a good life. But I love this country. I love the people of this country.
What's happened to our jobs? and the special interests, not special interests like what's happened. But we're getting wiped out. You go to Michigan, you go to, you go to New England, you look at areas around here, you look at what's happening. It's a one-lane highway into Mexico, no way out. They get the jobs, they get the money, they get the plans. I tell the story of my friend, he builds plans. He's the biggest in the world, he builds plans. That's what he does, that's what he wants to do. That's all he wants to do. If you said build an apartment, you would know how to go around.
Thank you.
To be a rich country, we must also be a safe country. We'll support local police and federal law enforcement in the matter to arrest and search our country. So far this year in Los Angeles, homicides have increased 27% over last year. And by the way, great Trojan horse. Modern day version of the great Trojan horse, not going to be us. A Trump administration will also secure and defend the borders of the United States. And yes, we will build a wall.
Strangled and beaten. With your own